One of the coolest things in a PC, kind of pun intended, is a liquid cooling unit. They've come so far. But today, I get to review one that's a little bit different. One I haven't reviewed in the past, an RGB AIO. I find it so cool, but today I get to bring you an unboxing and an overview of the AORUS Waterforce 240. With a bunch of great features, one of which being the RGB feature. But anyway, let's get to a quick unboxing so we can see everything that comes inside. So here we are again, the AORUS Waterforce 240. You can see here the two aRGB 120 millimeter fans with the AORUS logos right over here. These are graphene nano lubricated aRGB fans, by the way, so they are sleeve bearing. And one very cool thing about this, and I'll go over it in a little bit, and of course much more in detail during the install. Along the side here, AORUS CPU cooler, AORUS Waterforce 240. They show in here what it looks like inside of a system. The AORUS designing aRGB lighting. This over here tells you the temperature of the CPU, and we'll see that during the product usage and the install. The radiator and fans, AORUS designed cover. Then we see here the radiator and block, CPU socket support, which this does support Intel socket 2066, 2011, 2011-3, 1366, 115X series, 1200 and 1700 series. Then AMD TR4, STRX4 and AM4. Now the tube length is 380 millimeters long, and the material is rubber tube with nylon sleeve. Includes or uses the RGB Fusion 2.0 support software. Then right over here we can see the radiator. Here is 277 millimeters in length, 119.2 in width, and then 27 millimeters in height. Then the biggest one, or a big one over here, which causes a lot of issues with motherboards, is the height from the top all the way to the top of the fan. So 54.5 millimeters, definitely important. The radiator itself is 27 millimeters in height. Okay, then UPC, serial number, all that good stuff. Nothing along here. And down here, just marketing stuff. We'll go ahead and skip that for now. Let me bring you up over here. All right, just taking this off. At the very top, we have a diagram. AORUS Waterforce quick installation guide. Just goes over how to install it. And don't worry, again, we'll go over how to do this in my next video. So here it shows you everything that comes inside of the box, which is incredibly important. Not only to know, yeah, this comes in the box, but when you unbox it, you should verify every single thing is there. You don't want to be building it all of a sudden, hey, I'm missing that. You would have known if you mapped everything out at the beginning. Okay, then they show you here, install mounting bracket. It opens up. There's a lot more. Then they come with Team Up Fight On thermal paste. I don't know how good or bad this is, but because I am reviewing this, I will be using this thermal paste. And then over here, they go over, they have all of the brackets and all the everything. Let me go over that real quick. First off, the Intel backplate. This would clip onto the bottom of the board, and this would slide in through the holes. Over here, we have the TR4 TRX 40 bracket. Then we have the AMD mounting bracket. The Intel mounting bracket. AM4 screws, then four TR4s, STRX 40 screws, then a separate baggie with what looks like Intel screws. This one doesn't really have a name to it, but it comes with four of these little screw tight nuts, four LGA 2011 screws. See that right there? You'll notice right off the top that there's a screw on both ends. Top is a little bit thinner threading than the bottom. The bottom is relatively thick threading. And then four LGA 1700 screws. Much like the 2011 screws, there is threading on both sides. They are the same threading on both sides. And then four LGA 115X screws or 1150 series screws. Much like the 1700, it's thin threading both on the top and bottom. Then another baggie with a bunch of fan screws and additional screws. 8 fan screws. 8 of these very long screws with very fine threading. 8 washers, just basic washers. 8 radiator screws. It's kind of look like standoffs. A lot thicker threading back there. See that right here? And then where you would stick in a screw for the motherboard, but they're not standoff screws. And last for this baggy o' treats is 16 radiator screws. So 16 of these, rounded head up here, and then it has like a little hat around there. All right, now that we're done with those screws, then over here, we have 2 of the 120 millimeter fans. You can see they do have, it's not just a regular smooth fin. There is little folds right on here, supposedly to help with airflow. Then we can see the aRGB pin right down here. And then so that you could use it as a pass-through, an aRGB header, so you can connect that fan into here and then that one into something else. So definitely you won't be missing many aRGB headers. You'll just be using one. Then we have the 4-pin PWM header. And that's going to be the same thing on this fan as well. So the 4-pin PWM header, that way your motherboard or wherever you have this connected to will control the fan speed. We'll go over that during the install as well. Now just up close, you can see the radiator itself, the fins right over here. Now I'm not used to a 240, so it does feel incredibly small, but not everybody has room for a 280, a 360, or the monstrous 420. Sometimes 240 is all we have. Okay. Then again, even though it said it on the box, 27.90 millimeters, so that you can see that. 27.80 millimeters, which is funny because the box shows 27, so definitely the unboxing does help out. Then you throw in a fan, which this is definitely something that we'll all be incredibly interested in. So with a fan, we can see ...54.84, which the box reads 54.5. So now I'm also measuring from the thickest point. These rubber pads here, they are a little bit higher, but still you want to measure from the highest point because you never know where the motherboard could be in that spot where it becomes a pain in the butt. So now the hose, and I'll have measurements, the conversions listed down below. About 15 inches long, which is pretty standard. And they are nicely braided sleeves. All right, and then we can see right along here where the USB port or the USB would connect into the liquid cooling unit, the pump. And coming around over here. All right, so I'm just checking all around. Make sure before you install it to remove this and use that thermal paste. This does not bring any already applied. And then over here, let me take you a top view. Just a little bit easier to show you this from the top. So just peeling this off. So first off, they have a nice design here. Then we see the little AORUS eagle right over here. I like the way that that shows even when it's off. Now, another cool thing about this, you're basically only going to have one way to install it. Right over here, you can read that. It shows temp right over here. Okay, now, if you don't like the way that this looks in your case, you need it to be turned around, you can. I hate when I see the logo of a company on a pump and it's upside down or sideways here. You know, if you want it to be upside down, you have up to 330 degree movement, not a full 360, but hey, better than nothing, right? And now this guy measures 74.73 millimeters in height, which on the box it only shows 74. So it's nice when you have the points in there. You never know, just in case. So I'm pretty excited to see not only how this is going to perform, but be a little vain, how pretty it's going to look as well. And coming from the radiator itself, or should I say from the bottom of the hoses or the tubes, we can see there are two PWM connections right over here. Those would be for the fans to connect into here. And then as I showed you with the aRGB connections, these would plug into those two fans. And then there's an additional aRGB connection that can go into there as well. So trying to make it super easy. Then powering the entire thing would be one SATA power connection coming directly from the pump into your power supply. And then this USB connection comes in the box as well. So you would just plug this bad boy right into here. And then this end would go into a USB 2.0 header on your motherboard. Pretty simple, right? So the AORUS Waterforce 240. I know we just did the unboxing and an overview, but let me know what you think about it down in the comments. Do you love it? Do you hate it? You just can't wait to see the install video. And that's coming very soon. Actually, I couldn't find the right case in my gallery of cases to install it properly so that it not only looked nice, that worked at 100%. Mind you, I have the 7000D back here, which will fit any liquid cooling unit, but it's actually in the process of like four or five different reviews. So I bought its cousin. So I'm going to be doing a build off camera, which will be with no liquid cooling unit or no air cooling unit. And then in the video I'll be doing of the installation, I'll be using that system, showing you from start to finish how to install that. And then we're going to be doing some basic testing and everything so that you can see how it works. You want to see how it overclocks as well? Let me know down in the comments below. So as always, please do click like and subscribe. It helps me out a ton to get you bigger and better videos and product just like this. This is your friend Iggy with ThisBytesForYou out. See ya.